สวัสดีค่ะ Hello everyone, welcome to class Learn Basic Thai with a Native Speaker. My name is Tuk from Thailand. I've been teaching Thai to foreigners for over 6 years and now working in cooperation with Ling-App, so which is an incredible application for language learners. So I'm glad and very excited to be your teacher today. I hope you will enjoy my class and feel more motivated with learning Thai, even for the beginners. Please feel free and try to listen. Listening is the key because Thai language is a tonal language. So I talk about that later. Let's have a look at our agenda today. So we will start with the introduction to Thai language and go on with some basic Thai phrases. And at this point, you join me and practice together with me, okay? So after that, I'll be talking about two most popular Thai cultural events or festivals, which are Songkran and Loy Krathong. And after this part, so you may join me in answering some of my questions. And at the end of the sessions, I try my best, my colleague try our best to answer your questions about Thai language and the application link. All right, as you know, or for the beginners, Thai is the official language in Thailand, and Thai is a tonal language. It's got 5 different tones. This means the meaning of a word changes when it's pronounced with different tones. So let's have a look and let me move this bar like a little away. All right, so let's have a look at this example. You see Thai words here and the transcription for the beginners who are the beginners of learning Thai, and here is the meanings in English. So let's try with me. Feel free, try it at home. So the first one, the tone, pa. Second, pa. 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 So I do it one more time in a row and you too. Trying to hear the differences of the tone. Pa, 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 pa. Good job. I hope you guys repeated that and hear the differences. So we've got 44 consonants in Thai alphabet system. So there are 32 vowels, which are short and long vowels. And we have got 4 tone marks. One more time, we have got 4 tone marks. We have got 5 tones, but 4 tone marks. It means when you see the tone marks on top of the words, you can apply that. But some of the words, they don't have the tone marks. That means you have to learn the tone rules to get the tones correct. So, and let me introduce you the sentence structure. Thai language is like other languages. We start with subject, verb, and object, as in German or in English. Let's have an example here. This is a sentence in Thai. You see that we write all the words together, all together in a sentence. Okay, so I make it a little bit clearer for you. Here, I repeat after me. Chan Rian Pasa Thai. One more time. Chan Rian Pasa Thai. Good job. And now we have got 2 polite words. These polite words, you can add them at the end of the sentences or at the end of the phrases, any sentences. As women, get ready. Let's practice this word. Ka, ka. And now use it in the sentence. Chan rian phasa thai ka. Good job. Time for men. Polite word. Krap, krap. And try it in the sentence. But the men start with pom. Listen to me. Pom rian phasa thai krap. Good job. So for women, it's a little bit extra here. So for women, the word ka in the statement, listen to the tone. In the statement, we say ka, ka. But in the question, this word gets the other tone. Try to listen. Ka, ka. Okay, ka, ka. I hope you guys hear the difference. Later on in some phrases, you will hear this once again. We put it in the sentence, in the real conversation. All right, so get ready. You see this? Women, please. How to say hello in Thai. And the polite word added, women. Sa-wat-dii-ka. Sa-wat-dii-ka. Good job. Men, with the polite word. Sa-wat-dii-krap. Sa-wat-dii-krap. Well done. And now look at this posture. Look at this posture. We call the why. Why. Now let's practice this. So, your palms, try it. Your palms together. Put them onto your chest level. I do it a little bit lower. Here, chest level, not too low to your stomach, but not too high to your shin, just like this. Exactly. Palm together. Good job. And here, thumb, not too far away, but together, all together, exactly. Now, bend your head just a little bit, like this. One more time. See, very simple one. And now try together, women. Sa-wat-dii-ka. Men. Sa-wat-dii-krap. Good job. And this version of why is appropriate to everyone in every situation. You might, walk on the street and palm into your t-shirt and then you say, oh, that's my t-shirt. Sa-wat-dii-ka. That's it. It takes very quickly. All right. So let's move on. And now, how to ask, like, how are you? So get ready. Women first. And this is like a question. This is a question. The polite word for women changes the tone a little bit. Women, get ready. Sabai di mai ka. One more time. Sabai di mai ka. Men. Sabai di krap. Sabai di krap. Good job. So there is another phrase. It sounds more so relaxed, usual. This one. Get ready. Women first. Ben yangai bang ka. Faster. Ben yangai bang ka. Men. Ben yangai bang krap. Ben yangai bang krap. Good job. Keep practicing, keep repeating. So, all right. So you have learned the why ones. You greet people with why. You say thank you you can do this posture too. Let's try. Women first. ขอบคุณค่ะ Men. ขอบคุณครับ Good job. Let's move on. So, the posture of why goes for when you say sorry to. So, let's practice this one first. Just the word sorry or apologize. ขอโทษ ขอโทษ Good. Women. ขอโทษค่ะ ขอโทษค่ะ Men. ขอโทษครับ ขอโทษครับ Well done. I knew it. You did it well. I knew it. So, now, I would like to introduce you a very essential phrase here. When imagine you go to the local shop in Thailand. So, we use the word just how much, how much, how much. Point to anything and ask. Okay. Repeat after me, please. Women first. เท่าไหร่คะ One more time. เท่าไหร่คะ Good job. Men. เท่าไหร่ครับ เท่าไหร่ครับ Perfect. So as we talk about the price, how you ask about the price. So let's try to listen to the tone of the Thai numbers, 1 to 10, and repeat after me. When you repeat, you hear yourselves one more time. It's the best way to learn any language. So ready? So we have got here Arabic and the Thai one, but this is a Thai writing and the transcription. So get ready, guys, everyone together. หนึ่งสองสามสี่ห้าหกเจ็ดแปดเก้าสิบ I do it one more time.A little bit quicker in a row. So try to listen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Well done. So let's try this phrase, guys.So this is written like separately as a word, but you know, in Thai sentence, we would write them all together. But this is like easier for you to recognize the words, okay? So women, get ready. ฉันรักคุณค่ะ One more time, faster.ฉันรักคุณค่ะ Very good. Male, men. Start with ผม This is a word how men call themselves. I, ผม So get ready. ผมรักคุณครับ One more time. Faster. ผมรักคุณครับGood job. Okay. So let's try to have a small conversation from what we have practiced. So get ready. This is hello, women. Sa-wat-dii-ka.สวัสดีครับ Keep repeating. Don't forget to repeat after me. สบายดีไหมคะสบายดีครับขอบคุณครับ Good job. All right. One more conversation. One more conversation. We have learned about the prizes and a little bit of numbers. So we put them all together here. ขอโทษค่ะครับอันนี้ราคาเท่าไหร่คะ One more time. อันนี้ราคาเท่าไหร่คะอันนี้ราคา10บาทครับ One more time. อันนี้ราคา10บาทครับ Very good. So, I hope you guys kept repeating and listen to hearing your own sounds and being a little bit motivated. Now we have come to our upcoming event here in Thailand. Any one of you might have heard about Loy Krathong. Loy Krathong, please write down in the chat. Has any one of you done this before? Making your krathong by yourself and go to the river and float them onto the river. So Loy means float, you float, Loy. And krathong is this one. This is the krathong. The krathong is normally made from banana trunk, banana stem, banana leaves, and decorated with beautiful flowers. So we put one candle in there and three incense sticks in there. Before you float the krathong onto the river, so okay, you light up your candle and your incense sticks and raise them a little bit higher than your head or to the level of your head. And we apologize to the river that, okay, you might cause some water pollution there. So first you apologize to them and then you say thank you to them as the river's been supporting Thai people lives, especially in agriculture. And last but not least, don't forget to make wishes for yourself. Only good luck coming to you and float all the bad luck with the krathong, like far away from your lives. So that's what we do. And this event is gonna be held next week. This is November. It normally falls on the 12th month of lunar calendar, which is normally in November. And this year is next week on Friday. I'm going there. So I will wish all the good luck for you guys. All right. Next one is about the Songkran Festival. I'm quite sure that you guys, most of you have heard about this Songkran Water Festival. Some of you might have attended here. Some of you have heard about the Siloam Street or Khao San Road in Bangkok. This event is normally in April, and we actually celebrate our Thai New Year. It's normally on the 13th April to 15th April, but people might take more days off. So they go visit their families at the rural areas. It sounds like the Christmas for you, that you go visit your parents, you go visit your families, you gather together and having nice time together. Traditionally, in the morning, people go to the temple. So make merit there, give some food to the monk. And after that, they come back home. So having their own parties, so eating, grill, and drinking, you know, like talking in the family. And what they do is traditionally, they bath the elderly people, like bathing the elderly people and wishing them live long lives. And of course the elderly people wish you as a younger ones, having like success life, success, work, and being healthy. So after that, maybe in the late afternoon, younger people might go splashing water somewhere in your hometown. So in Bangkok, like very famous place is Siloam Wan's and Khao San Road. I think most of you like have heard about this, but in every province in Thailand, so the local organization will have these events for people like to go and have fun there. This is really fun tradition for like tourists. You are all welcome to Thailand and having like water splashing with Thai people. So now we have come to our quizzes. So feel free and answer this question, please write down in the chat. How many tone marks does the Thai language have? Tone marks? The tone marks. Answer please, answer please. Cool. 5, Jinyoung 4, Alex, okay. All right, wow, you guys are good. Thank you for that, 504. So we have got only 4 tone marks. You guys, we have got 5 tones, but 4 tone marks. Okay. You have, okay, as I told you, we have got only 4 tone marks, so written on the words, but 5 tones. Oh, what it means? That means you have to learn the tone rules for those words that don't have the tone marks on it. Okay, but in general, we have got 4 tone marks. Okay, good job. The last question, please. What does this sentence mean? Most of you might not be able to read this, but I will do that for you. Listen carefully, listen carefully. Ben yangai bang. One more time. Ben yangai bang. What does it mean? Please write down your answer in the chat. Oh, very quickly. Good job. You all have got the right answer. It's how are you? How are you? Ben yangai bang. Alex, ben yangai bang. Jonathan, ben yangai bang. Okay, Lee Vong, ben yangai bang. Good job, guys. I hope you guys are a little bit motivated and feel like active to start learning Thai or keep learning Thai. So, thank you. Thank you so much for answering, for participating. So, and now, please welcome Liu from our Ling-App to explain you all about the app and who guys have got here, the prizes. Thank you. ขอบคุณค่ะ.
ขอบคุณค่ะ. Thank you for an amazing lesson. I really enjoy it. And I can also learn more about Thai phrases and Thai culture. So thank you. ขอบคุณมากค่ะ. Right, so for the prizes, I would love to share with all of you in this class today. All of you will get 14 days free to learn 60 languages with the Ling-App, and you will have a chance to win a lifetime pro version. We will pick randomly 5 people, and then we will send you an email. So you will get full access to all languages, all content in the Ling-App lifetime. So make sure you scan the QR code or click the link in the comment in the chat box. I send it there. And this offer only lasts for like 3 days until this Sunday. So make sure you claim it right now, otherwise you might miss it. And if you want to learn more about Thai grammar, Thai pronunciation, and more phrases, we have weekly free Thai lessons with a native speaker, with our teacher. And today we will start at 2:30 CET. So you can also scan the QR code or click the link in the chat box and save your time and join the class and have fun there. Right, I will give you a few seconds to click the link and scan the QR code. So don't miss this, right? You'll get 14 days free on the Ling-App. Right. So for those who don't know about the Ling-App yet, I would love to give a brief introduction. Right. Next slide, please. So the Ling-App, which is like a language app, we have 60 languages there, from the popular one like French or English or German to the less popular one like Thai or Serbian. And it has been featured on the App Store since September. A lot of influencers also recommended Ling to the audience. So you should try it out. You can learn languages with mini games, quizzes, and you can check your pronunciation, learn how to write the alphabet in some languages, and you can listen to the audios and try to repeat after them, like one by one, because the audios are recorded by native speakers. And you can learn with the Ling-App on Android or iOS, mobile phones or tablets, or you can also learn on a laptop with our web version. So check it out at lingapp.com. Our website is under the image, or you can also click the link in the chat box, right? So I would like to go back to the last screen a little bit so people can have some time to get the free 14 days free at the Ling-App and have a chance to win a lifetime pro version and save your time. After this workshop, then you can join the Ling, the Thai class with our native speaker. Right, thank you. And right, so I think we can move to the next part, which is Q&A. If you have any questions, please write down in the chat box as well. I saw that you sent a couple of questions earlier that, right, I answered some of them. So hopefully if you have more questions, ขอบคุณค่ะ. Right, so one person asked, Lee asked, are there no punctuation marks in Thai writing, like question marks?
No, we actually don't. We don't have question mark, we don't have full stop, we don't, comma is used in some, but not really. In Thai, real Thai language, we don't have this. Mm-hmm. But right now, you might see that like a lot more, because like younger people in the chat or not official language, so they use that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm, that's cool.
All right.
Right. So if you have any other questions, you can also contact us on our website, lingapp.com. We can move back to that screen so people can see the website link. Right, lingapp.com. And then you can also leave your comments, your questions there. We would love to receive a lot of questions from you, and we will answer all of them. And we will pick 5 random people to send you the emails and, you know, give you the pro version lifetime. Right. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining today. And we would love to have you joining. And we hope that you learn a lot of Thai today as well. Thank you.